Hello learners, today we will discuss chapter number 3 of income tax, that is exempted incomes. What is the meaning of exempted income? Exempted income is that on which no income tax is chargeable. Such income do not be included in total income, either fully or partially. Under section 10, all incomes are included which are totally tax free. These incomes do not form part of either gross total income or total income of an assessee, as these incomes are not chargeable to income tax. Section 10 classifies exempted incomes into three categories: income exempted for all assessees, income exempted for employees, income exempted for institutions. First of all, we will discuss exempted incomes for all assessees. First one is agricultural income. If the agricultural land is situated in India, such income is fully exempted. Amount received by family member from HUF. Any amount received by family member of HUF from the income belonging to HUF is fully exempted. Share of income received from a firm. In case any partner receives any share of income from a firm, the receipt in the hands of partner is fully exempted from tax. But if a partner receives any amount in the form of salary, bonus, commission, interest, etc., it will be taxable under the head profit and gains of business or profession. Next one is payment received by a person under Bhopal Gas Leak Disaster Act 1985. Such payment of compensation is fully exempted from tax. Amount of compensation received regarding disaster. Any amount received by a person himself or by his or her legal heirs from central or state government or local authority, it is exempted. Sum of life insurance money received. Any sum of amount received including bonus on account of life insurance is fully exempted. Educational scholarships. Any amount of money received from government for pursuing education to meet educational cost or expenses, it will also be exempted. Dividend. Any amount received as a dividend from a domestic company is exempted from tax. Family pension received by legal heirs. Any sum received by a member of armed forces, maybe a widow or a children or legal heirs, such pension is fully exempted in the hands of legal heirs. Income of minor. Under section 10, subsection 32, minor may be a girl or a boy who is less than 18 years. Income of minor will be added in his or her parents' total income when the income of minor child is clubbed in the income of parent. Then that parent is eligible for getting exemption of actual amount or rupees 1500 in respect of each minor child, whichever is less. Allowances of member of parliament, member of legislative assemblies, or member of legislative constituencies. Entire amount of daily allowances received is fully exempted. Any other allowances received by any MP is fully exempted. If any MLA received any constituency allowance under any act or rules by that state legislative, then it will be fully exempted. Awards in the form of cash or in kind. If any reward approved by central government or state government or by any other body in public interest is given, then it is fully exempt. Pension of gallantry awardees, recipient of Paramveer Chakra or Mahavir Chakra or Veer Chakra or other such gallantry awards given by central government, if such recipient is receiving any pension, it shall be fully exempt. Annual value of one palace of rulers of Indian state. If any ruler of an Indian state is in occupation of palaces, then annual value of one palace of his choice is fully exempt. Incomes of scheduled tribes. If any income which accrues or arises to member of tribal area from any source or by way of dividend or interest in interest on securities are fully exempt. State of Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Mizoram, Sikkim, Nagaland, Tripura, Ladakh region of Jammu and Kashmir are considered as tribal areas. Sudden incomes of Sikkimese. If an individual being a Sikkimese get any income in the form of interest on securities or a dividend, then it shall be exempt. But if a Sikkimese woman got married with non-Sikkimese on and after April 1, 2008, she will not be entitled for such exemption. Then interest on incomes are fully exempted. Any amount of money received under a life insurance policy, including amount allocated by way of bonus, shall be fully exempted. In the following cases, amount received shall not be exempted. Number one, if any amount received from life insurance company on the insurance of dependent handicapped member. When a dependent or any family member is suffering from a notified disease. Any amount received under scheme and insurance policy. In these three cases, amount received will not be exempted. Any payment received from Sukanya Samriddhi account shall be exempted if that account is being opened in accordance with this scheme under Rule 2014. Any amount withdrawn either from statutory provident fund or from public provident fund is exempt. Besides the above discussed exempted incomes, there are other exempted incomes which shall be covered under various heads too. Next, we will discuss about income exempted for employees. There are certain incomes like leave travel concession to an employee, death come retirement gratuity, computation of pension, leave salary or encashment of earned leave, allowances of perquisites received outside India, compensation received on retrenchment, payment received from a statutory provident fund, payment received from recognized provident fund, payment received from approved superannuation fund, house rent allowances received subject to certain conditions. We will discuss these in detail under the head salaries. Third case is incomes exempted for institutions. Certain incomes of local authority, income of khadi and village industry board set up under the State Act, income of South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation Fund, income of specified charitable funds, income of mutual fund, income of pension fund established by Life Insurance of India or any other insurance company, income of professional institutions subject to the fulfillment of certain conditions, incomes of a body for promoting interest of scheduled caste or scheduled tribes, income of certain authorities established or appointed to manage religious or charitable institutions, income of a European Economic Community, any income of Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India shall be exempted. Any income received by a person on the behalf of funds set up by the central government shall be exempt. There are other exempted incomes also, which we will discuss in the different heads of income. Now, it's a time to have an assignment. First question is, discuss any 15 incomes which are totally exempt from tax. Sometimes a tricky question is being asked by the examiner. These tricky questions are indirectly asked in the form of statements. The answer of these statements are being given in the introduction part of the chapter, or you will find it in the meaning of the concept. So keep it in mind, this thing, that introduction or meaning is utmost important. You may be asked that explain the incomes which are neither included in total income nor income tax is payable on them by the assessee. The answer will be same. For this, I have referred to these books. Thank you so much. Have a nice time.